दिस क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड इन द सीबीएसई एग्जामिनेशन, ईयर वाज 2001, सेट सी. एंड द क्वेश्चन इज इवैल्यूएट एज अ लिमिट ऑफ सम इंटीग्रल 0 टू 2 एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 3 डीएक्स. नाउ यू नो दैट इफ In evaluate simply was written, we would have directly done it as x cube upon 3 plus 3x, put the limits, got the answer. But this time, it is written evaluate as the limit of sum. You have to do it by the limit of sum method only. So let's start with it. It is not that difficult. I write solution and let's start. So I know that certain things have to be defined. What is A? What is B? What is NH? NH is equal to B minus A. We started in the first video based on definite integration as a limit of sum, right? So A is what? The lower limit, which is 0. B is what? The upper limit, which is 2. NH is what? B minus A. So N, I don't know what is the value. H, I don't know, but B minus A I know. 2 minus 0 is 2. So I can write that H is equal to 2 upon N. This can be found out. Right? What is my fx? Fx is my, the function, x square plus 3. Now directly, let's go for the solution. So I write integral a to b fx, fx is x square plus 3 dx. So the solution further should be, for this integral, I know the formula limit h tends to 0, h f of a plus f of a plus h plus f of a plus 2h and so on till f of a plus n minus 1 into h. Right? Now you see how to do it further. Very simple. I know that limit h tends to 0. What is the value of h? It is 2 upon n. And f of a. F of a is what? A is the lower limit, which is 0. So f of 0, f of a plus h is f of 0 plus h plus f of 0 plus 2h and so on till f of 0 plus n minus 1 into h. Right? The next step. The next step should be limit h tends to 0, 2 upon n as it is. Please do not make a mistake while understanding n and h. Some people write both of the same manner. Now, f of 0 means what? Here you put 0, 0 plus 3 is 3, plus f of 0 plus h means f of h. Here you put h, h square plus 3, plus f of 2h. F of 2h means here you put 2h, so 2h whole square plus 3, and so on till the end. So it should be n minus 1 square h square plus 3. Now you see, let's take certain things common. Limit h tends to 0, 2 upon n, 3, 3, 3 and so on till the last term. Total number of terms n, so 3n plus h square, h square, h square from everywhere except the first term, means h square you take, so it is 3, sorry, h square you take, so you are left with 1 here, so it is nothing but 1. Plus 2 square plus 3 square and so on till the last term here. So n minus 1 whole square. Now you see, I have limit h tends to 0, 2 upon n. 3n is here, fine. Let me introduce certain things here. Let me actually make this very easy to understand by introducing this 2 upon n inside. So it is 3 2s are, which is 6, and n getting cancelled, plus 2 into this thing. So 2 upon n multiplied by h square. What is h? H is 2 upon n. So it is 4 upon n square. Then inside you have to apply the formula 1 square 2 square till n minus 1 whole square, which is n. N minus 1, 2n minus 1 whole over 6. Now cancel certain things. I have n getting cancelled with n. I have 2 getting cancelled here. Now as you can see, for the further part, let's move here. So it is 6 plus 4 upon 3. So it should be 4 upon 3. And these n and n go to the other side here. So it is n minus 1 upon n multiplied by 2n minus 1 upon n, and n tends to infinity. So, seen if n tends to infinity, what can I do? Here only I am making the changes. This should be nothing but n upon n. So, it is 1. This was what? Let's see it again. This was nothing but n minus 1 upon n. First, let me write it this way. So, it can be separated. Here also you see, it is 2n upon n minus 1 upon n. So, it is 2n upon n minus 1 upon n. Now, n and n getting cancelled. So, this is nothing but 1. Here also, n and getting cancelled. So, it is 2. Now, one more thing is very important to understand what it is. It was limit, which I can write here, limit n tends to infinity. If limit is n tends to infinity, 1 upon n will make it 0. So, this vanishes. Here also, 1 upon n is 0, so this vanishes. So finally, for the solution part, what all terms are left? 6 plus 4 upon 3 multiplied by 2. So it is 6 plus 8 upon 3. So what should be the answer? It should be 26 upon 3. And that is the answer to this question. So please pay attention how to solve it. A small mistake can lead to a big blunder. So keep practicing, keep learning.